I have absolutely no idea what model of instrument this is. Or there it is, an RBX-374. Oh, what just happened on the back here? I didn't even see that when Buddy dropped it off. Interesting. I'm not going there. Oh, look, it was $339 at Lon McQuaid with its guts hanging out. So I noticed that in the jig bag that came with this. Oh no, Buddy said he made it work. And it doesn't work because there's no battery. Well, what the hell? Well, I cobbled a battery into it. I'm sure I could do something better for a cover than they had. Is it gonna light up? Because otherwise, the guy told me it did, but. Oh, frick, yeah, she buzzes and hums like a bumblebee. Holy guacamole. Okay, we've solved that, but that battery box thing has gotta be. Gotta get fixed. Okay, the age-old question. Does this actually work? Doesn't look like anybody's really wrecked it. Oh, and it's one of those. Where's that little wrench that I ground down about 10 years ago to get in there? Is that the guy? Yeah, that's it. Really don't want to tighten. She seems pretty tight, and it needs to get tighter. Come on, you can do it, Davey. Oh well, it moves. There's hope. There is hope. Let's get these strings off. And like I said, this wins the award for the driest fingerboard I've ever seen in my life. As always, all the tuner bushings are loose. Those are tightened. And they're all, this isn't easy. They're all sunk way down in there for some reason. Fix that up before we carry on. There, that's better. All the tuners aren't wiggling. So I definitely have to do a before and an after. So let's put some love on that. The fingerboard is so dry, I have to do two passes. So, once again, looked like somebody used something really not good, like possibly rubbing alcohol or water. I know there's individuals out there that think water is the answer. If you want to clean that, I'm not cleaning it with the linseed oil, just to be clear. It's being sucked into the grain of the wood, keeping it from splitting. You can always already see the heavy splits in the fingerboard because it's really just dried out. Wow, that's crazy. Let's carry on. That was actually three passes of linseed oil, and wow, I couldn't. That's wild. Okay, we're cleaned up. I did a little preemptive strike on the truss rod before I put the strings on. Today we are getting DR neon green. I'm not sure why, but that's what we're getting. So give me a couple minutes, we'll put those on and we'll just make this work right. It's got to go to the church tomorrow, so I'm on this. These just look so wrong on so many levels. It reminds me of being back at work doing special effects against a green screen. By the end of the day, you'd have a green screen headache. You're not supposed to meant to see that color all the time.
It's such a great day today. I actually have the window open. It's like nice out, 20 Celsius. Let me find the right tools and let's see what the neck is doing. But hey, I gotta say this. They did a thing here, and for years, I've always, like I play P bass, and I've always rested my thumb on the pickup. and they've actually done little divots in here. I think that's the coolest thing I've seen in a long time, because I just went to play it and rested my thumb there and went, wow, what a cool idea. And then you could do it back here too, right? Okay, I gotta get some stuff. The neck relief is very close. We're gonna just give it another little twist and hopefully get it to where it needs to be. Hey, who knew? I mean, it's kind of weird looking, but it is really light and it is balanced, and I don't know, I guess if they made me, I'd be able to use it. Okay, I'm gonna stop there. We're cranking the neck, we'll do all the other adjustments. But the other gag with this was, they need it back for church tomorrow, and I'm going, buddy, it should sit for at least a day. It's like, which brings me to things that come back once in a while. I like to get everybody to try their stuff when they come over. Make sure they like it, because we can always do some final adjustments. But sometimes what happens is, that string's too high. Those strings are both too high. What happens is, you know, my house is different than your house. Things have been out of adjustment for a long time. So we try to put them back, and we'll let the guitar sit and just make sure it likes everything we did, because that will bite you. Might come down a little snuggle here, but hey, no neck shim needed. The strings are adjusting down to where they should be. Kind of a weird bridge though too. A lot of parts that don't really need to be there, but that's how they did it. Once again, making sure that the bridge saddles aren't cockeyed and riding on one screw and not both. That's still got to come down. And when you get it right, if you want to change the string action, and I've said this to guys before, because once I fiddle around here for the next 15 minutes getting this square, if you want the string action higher, right, what you need to do is take your wrench and move every screw the same amount. Because everything is cut in threads per inch, so if you twist it the same amount, it will back itself up or push itself in by the same amount. And without even any tools, really, if you're careful, like I said, I'm tweaking every string to get this right, but once it's right, if you wanted everything to go up, just turn every screw up half a turn or dump it down half a turn, but you can't screw with each string individually, because that messes with the radius of the fingerboard that I'm trying to match right now, so that this plays nicely and your fingers float across the strings. I think I'm almost there. Well, I guess we're into a quick pickup height check. What I find with a lot of these guitars is there's not a lot of adjustability, so we're way too close with the pickups on this right now. Let's see if they move. If they don't move, well, I can't do anything. Oh, it's dunking down. Hey, dunking down. Dunkin' Donuts. Yeah. So again, if the pickups are too close, the string doesn't have enough room to do its amplitude, right? It's like a skip rope. Mm. too far away, we don't create enough electricity, and too close, we choke the amplitude of the string so that it can't produce as much electricity as it could, because it's being choked without being able to flop around as much as it should be able to away from the magnet, right? That one's getting close. I'll get this. And so if anybody cares about the numbers, that's 1/8 of an inch thick. Push the last fret. I should just snuggle under there. On the treble side, because the strings are skinnier, the pickup needs to be a slightly bit closer. And this will be 3/32, so I dump those down way too much. So pop those back up a little bit. Hopefully they'll move. Pretty sure it's foam under there, which, like I said, over time turns to dust. That one brought it up too much. And this one needs to come up a little bit. Sure, we'll rock with that. Okay, installation.
Yeah, so I fixed up all that loop-de-loop on the back and got the wires back inside the base. If you were really interested, you could probably make a nicer cover out of something else, but I know it's a low budget, so the new cover will be a piece of black Gorilla tape. It'll be fine.
They always seem to get the intonation right. They have center positions, so those are all centers. A little chatter there. I don't want to get my gooey fingers all over the green, because you know what's going to happen to these? They're just going to turn brown in all the spots where you play on the bass. Check. I just want to see what the string height's doing. It still feels not as easy to play as I'd like it to be. Probably squeak it down a little bit. But once again, now they're all set to the same height. Right? If I just do like this, quarter turn on everybody, I'm going to be safe. And I think that is going to be exactly the amount to get this right where I'd like it to be. We'll retune. And once again, watching that, we're not riding on one tire here, right? What do we get before I retune? It's not that critical. Check, recheck, and check again. That, I'm gonna say, D string needs to still dunk down a little here. Maybe even another hair. How many hairs do we have? As always, Dave's rule is to set it aside for at least, I like to wait till tomorrow, right? I'm a man of tomorrow. I'm a man of the future. Everything will get done tomorrow, don't worry. Pickup and some sort of noise boost. Oh yeah. Active electronics.
Anyway, thanks for hanging out, folks. Some sort of silvery Yamaha. What was it called?
Again?
RBX374. Right. It's very silvery. Now it's silvery and green. It's as good as it is. Thanks for hanging out, folks. All the links to things are below if you don't know. And most of all, be good to each other. Cheers.